Hey, we're going to be making some hands today. Don't miss the video. Today we're going to be working on hands. I took an image from one of my videos and I am going to be working on this holding a pencil. You can just go online and check all kinds of hands from classical paintings or actors or just a regular Google search on hands, or even in Pinterest, where you can see how the hands are. But if you find something that you like, just take the photo and work in your journal, in your sketchbook. There is a billion of styles that you can try. See which one is more interesting to you. If you are a total beginning on drawing or in drawing hands, don't aim for something too complicated and too realistic, because I don't want you to feel sad because, or frustrated because the sketch is not going where you want it. What I want you to do is do at least 4 tries of the same posture of the hand, just a simple outline style, and then we're going to be working on different things like adding shadows and highlights. I will make a different video for the acrylic painting, but for now I want you to see the posture of the hand and the shapes. It's easier if we see things in different shapes, like for example this over here is like a shape of a kind of like a square. It's easier if you see everything in little squares. Over here is another shape. Pentagon of sorts. And then from every little division comes these little tubes, which are more little squares. All of them. The thumb comes from inside of this main shape as another little set of squares. And in this particular photo, you only have one fingernail. But you have to observe the lines, not so much right now the shadows and all the other complicated parts of a hand, but just the basic lines to make the hand. And of course, the pencil, right? So let's work on the sketchbook, the art journal here. I'm going to open the screen a little more. Let's see if this way looks better. Okay, we're going to start from the bottom of the picture. And I would have more room if I was to work like in this format, but I like to keep my paintings mostly on this side, so it's going to have to be a little smaller so that it fits, right? That's another thing that we have to consider, to scale the proportion of our work. So the hand is a little bit of an angle, and then it goes in another angle like this, and a little curve this way. I'm making it much longer, but I have my eraser. If I go too crazy one side or another, I can erase and start again. And do not work too hard with your pencil. Then you mark the paper and then you'll have a mess. So that's a very important tip to do. Very, very fine lines as we are just beginning, okay? Then in over here, I see this line that is in a less of an angle, almost actually straight like with this. And over here, it opens into a bit of a curve. It goes like a little curve and then it flares out. I could do the square that I have here. Actually, I'm going a little too big. I'm going to run out of room for my fingers. I could do this and then this other part like this. Instead of stretching on this size, I am scaling down, right? The little curve goes like this, and from here goes this part right here. So in the little curve, I just throw this line and then it goes up. Not that it matters much at this point, but I just want to put it in there. Then I have this little area over here. And if you see, it's one little box, a small little box, because of the angle where it is. It's not like this, it's aiming to the front. So one of the little squares is pretty much a little shorter than this, just a little bit. And then the other little shape over here, you can make it first as a square or a rectangle and then make the little curve when you're ready, or just go straight to make these little squares over here and then the round dip, right? So we're gonna make the little square and then we make the other little square and then we make the little curvature. This is kind of not in proportion because I was being so careful not to go too far away that I made it kind of all scrunched up. So I'm going to start again. It's one square, another square, and then the little curvy part. And then over here by this area, there's a little space, right? And we have, after that little space, another curve. This finger is close to it, so we may as well put the two together. And if you see, it's pretty much the same space or the same width. But this one, at this point, they take different directions. This one goes this way, and then it goes in the little other curve. This one goes more kind of like straight over here. And then if you notice, it goes kind of like a falling a little bit this way. Very basic lines, okay? Don't get too scared if this is like discombobulated or something, because then we will go again with more softer and refined lines. Then this one is hidden partially by the pencil. So if I had a ruler, which, let me see. Well, let's work first on the thumb, which at this point where it grows a little wider, it comes back again inside, makes a little bit of a line. Well, from this line, we have ways to go for the first fold. So this would be my first line in here, and then it grows this way, and the nail is not like this, and it's not a square like centered, it's taking from this distance to this distance, pretty much like almost two-thirds. If this was, well, just part half actually, from here to here, half would be here, and this is a little bit more towards the center, and then it reaches almost to the top, but doesn't pass on this side. So we do this. We go a little more like this. All right. So, and from here, a little taller is the first little square for this part of the finger. And then the other one is angled in more. And then the third part that is kind of like falling, but not quite. And that is telling me that I made this drawing like this instead of like this. So I will fix that by making this more separated. So this one still has room over here. And then we have the line that goes around here, kind of hidden, and pass the thumb. And with that, I can tell you, I can see where my mistake is. So I can correct that. Plus also I'm working, instead of having the paper or the page right in front of me, I have the angle over here. Because of the camera, so it's a little complicated. Yeah, all it takes is that I grab a camera to start making all kinds of mistakes, right? Usually that's how it goes. So I'm going to look close to my own face to see, okay, the fingers are a bit too short. So I'm going to stretch my lines just the same way. And then over here, after this line goes in here, there's another one that goes this way, and then another one that goes this way, and from these there's a series of little wrinkles that come over here like so, and you have a hand. So now what I'm going to do is just erase a little bit of the extra lines that we don't need. So, ways to do this. You can get a fine micron. This one, where's the number? It's a 1, so it's still way too thin for this, but like a number 8 would be fine if you just wanted like a sketch or a drawing. You could make the outline with a pit pen. If you wanted to make it more like an illustration type, you can make it with this type of water-soluble pencils. I will find all of these in Amazon and put them in a link in my information box below this video in case that you want to get some. you can purchase from there and help my channel, because that's a really easy way to shop, have fun, and send a couple of cents my way. And also this charcoal pencil that you can just draw around and go rub it around to make the shadowing all over the place. I love this, but I'm not going to be doing that right now with this. So I am going to be using one of these, which is pretty much, this is the sketch and wash, which I totally love. They will move again if you add more water. So these have to be set with some medium or with your paint, but you have to be careful because the paint will drag them all over the place as well. You can either spray or go very gently, following around with a thin brush, and that way you make sure that whatever line that you put in there is gonna stay there, and then you can add your color. Or if you like a more loose and painterly way, which is also another style of doing things, you just play with whatever mess that is happening and you just leave it in there as a playful painterly shadowing and highlights. Everything is pretty much okay because there's so many styles and ways to do the same thing that it is only the practice that will make you know which way you like it better. So that is why I told you before to make several, make at least four, if 5, 6, or 10, even better. Make one with a marker, one with pencil, one with charcoal. You could try later on to go just with paint once you feel comfortable of where these little squares and shapes will take you, what is needed to make it look like a hand. Don't be afraid of not knowing how to draw to paint. Some people say that you must be a perfect sketcher if you want to be a perfect painter. I personally don't believe that. I think that you can make a very abstracted drawing and paint and put all the passion and colors and measurements into the paint. Or you can have a gorgeous sketch, but if you don't know how to paint and how to do how to treat the paint, if it is oils or if it is acrylics or watercolors or pastels, then you mess up your sketch. So both things are as important, but they can be independent from each other. You can have, like I said, a very rudimental sketch and put all the work on the highlights and shadows on the paint, or go from a more detailed drawing, but don't let the drawing or lack of experience stop you. Because I rather have fun in practice than stop because this wasn't perfect and I messed up. You know what happens when you mess up? Change the page, start anew. If it is like too important because this was the whatever page of your whatever day, then paint around it. Acrylics are very forgiving, oils are awesome too, but they take longer time, and I do not recommend to use them for an art journal. I rather just put those in a canvas. However, don't stop because of the line going crooked or some other whatever mistake. Keep going and love all those ugly steps, love all those ugly pages, all those ugly canvases, because those are the stepping stones to the path you want to follow. So do not give up. Anyway, I'm going to be using my water-soluble pencil and later on add color. So over here, I'm going to be more, not detail, but a little more with a softer continuous line that might correct a couple of things from the drawing. So here we are. What do you think? It is not perfect, but it looks like a hand. So, after we have this, we are going to go and get some water and a skinny brush, and we are going to be following the line and the paint, the pencil actually is going to move a little bit. That's what we want because it's going to give more highlights and more of a, how can I say this? More artistic presence to your drawing. Now, the light over here is towards the bottom. Check on your particular paint, picture, where the shadows are, because that's where you want to rub your brush a little more. And the pencil will make another type of shadow, another more darkened area. I'm going to add the color in the next video. So thanks for watching. Click like if you like this video. And remember to keep your paintbrush wet.